So friends, the next point is that till date, we have finished about the, that started about the chemical preservatives, and we have completed this benzoic acid, that table sugar and salt, then later on benzoic acid, sorbic acid, lactic acid. Now today we are going to see here. So these lactic acid, it is the main product of the different types of food fermentations. And this is produced or formed by the microbial breakdown or degradation of the sugars present in the food products here. For example, the sugars which is present in the sauerkraut or in pickles. So this fermentation of this sauerkraut or sugars present in the sauerkraut or sugars present in the pickles, that will causes the fermentation, and there is a formation of lactic acid. So this lactic acid produced in such fermentation, so they decreases the pH to the level where or in which that microorganisms cannot grow, or that pH is unfavorable for the growth of microorganisms as well as for the spoilage caused by such microorganisms. So that spoilage, that may be the type of putrefaction we can say here, putrefaction by the anaerobic microorganisms, or that may be the production of butyric acid by the microorganisms. So इस फर्मेंटेशन की वजह से जो लैक्टिक एसिड यहाँ पे प्रोड्यूस होता है, सो दिस लैक्टिक एसिड ये पीएच कम कर देता है, एंड दिस लो पीएच ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर फूड मटेरियल नाउ बिकम्स अनफेवरेबल फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स और फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ स्पॉइलेज कॉजिंग माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. सो दैट मे बी द प्यूट्रीफैक्टिव माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट आर एनएरोबिक माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, और दैट मे बी द ब्यूटरिक एसिड प्रोड्यूसिंग माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. At the same time, that yeast and molds generally, because we know that yeast and molds, they can grow at the low pH values. So here, though there is a lactic acid is there, though the pH is level, pH is less. So at that time also, that yeast and molds, they can grow at these low pH values, but that can be controlled by the addition of some other preservatives, for example, sorbate or the benzoate. Because pH कम है, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि कौन से भी प्रकार की बैक्टीरिया माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स यहाँ पे ग्रो नहीं होंगी, लेकिन यहाँ पे कुछ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऐसे हैं जैसे कि मोल्ड्स एंड ईस्ट है, दे कैन ग्रो एट द लो पीएच वैल्यूज. तो इस टाइप के फर्मेंटेशन में ये माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, ये मोल्ड एंड ईस्ट यहाँ पे ग्रो हो सकते हैं या होते हैं, तो दैट कैन बी प्रिवेंटेड, और द ग्रोथ ऑफ दिस माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट कैन बी प्रिवेंटेड बाय द एडिशन ऑफ सम अदर केमिकल प्रिजर्वेटिव्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सॉर्बेट और द बेंजोएट. So this is about the lactic acid. Next point is here, that is called as sulfur dioxide and sulfides. So this sulfur dioxide and the sulfides that can be added to the food material, for example, in dried fruits, in fruit pulp, as well as in juices and in molasses, to increase or to extend their shelf life or to prevent the spoilage of these foods here. And these sulfur dioxide and sulfides, they can conserve. Yes.
So what is dried fruits?
Dried fruits, dried. The spelling mistake yahan pe hai.
Okay.
So these type of preservative, that is sulfur dioxide and sulfides, they conserve the color of the food material. At the same time, they act as antioxidants, and at the same time, they control the growth of microorganisms, or they inhibit the growth of microorganisms. And the sulfur dioxide as well as that sulfides, they dissolve in water, and at low pH values, they produces the sulfurous acid, bisulfite, as well as sulfite ions. And these products which are produced at the low pH values in that particular food, they, for example, here that sulfite salt, they contain 50 to 68% active sulfur dioxide. And this pH dependent equilibrium, which is formed in the water, due to the and the proportion of that sulfur dioxide ions or sulfur dioxide in water, that increases with decreasing pH value. मतलब जैसे जैसे pH value कम होती जाएगी, वैसे वैसे ये जो sulfite salts है या फिर sulfurous acid है, sulfite ions है, ये वहाँ पे या फिर उनका concentration वहाँ पे बढ़ता जाएगा, and that's why they will protect or they will preserve that food material from the spoilage as well as from the microbial growth. And at pH values which are less than 4, then the antimicrobial activities at this pH, which is in that foods, for example, which has the pH values less than 4, So there is a maximum antimicrobial activity is there because as the pH value is less, then the antimicrobial activity is high. Okay, मतलब जितनी pH values वहाँ पे कम होती है उतना सीधा मतलब है कि that particular environment or that food it becomes more acidic, and if that food become more acidic, so there is a less possibility of growth of bacteria generally, and that means the antimicrobial activity of such foods will be high. Okay, and in the past, that cut fruits as well as vegetables in salads, they were spread or they were dipped in a solution of sulfites to preserve for longer duration. But now the at the same time that sulfur inhibits the enzymatic browning of the food material or the fruits and keeps that plant tissues for, fresh for the longer duration. Okay, so that means that sulfur, which is a one compound we can see here, that sulfur and sulfur compounds. So this sulfur, it inhibits the enzymatic activity which causes the browning of the food material, and that's why that food material can be remain fresh for the longer duration. But using of this sulfur as a practice, generally this is banned by the Food and Drug Administration, that is by the FDA, because there were more about or more than 100 cases were reported in which there is an adverse reaction takes place and that causing the death also. Okay, so that's why that Food and Drug Administration, they banned the use of this sulfur, though they are inhibiting the enzymatic activity, though they are keeping that food material or that plant tissues fresher for longer duration. But because of this incident, because of these cases which are reported, death cases which are reported, so that FDA banned the use of sulfur in the food material. And approximately 5 to 11% of the asthmatics or persons who are suffering from the asthma, they are sensitive to the sulfates and they experience different symptoms if they eat food material which consists of sulfur dioxide or sulfates in that food material. So they experience these symptoms, for example, headaches, nausea, then abdominal pains as well as dizziness. So that's why that means it causing some side effects we can say here, and that's why that FDA they banned the use of this sulfur or sulfite compounds, so that that persons or those persons who are suffering from the asthma, they does not become ill or they does not show such type of symptoms. Then next one is here, carbon dioxide. So in the controlled or the modified environment where there is a storage of fruits and vegetables is there, then there is a correct combination of that oxygen and the carbon dioxide. If there is a concentration, we can say proper or the equal concentration of that oxygen, equal in the sense, not equal, but correct combination of that oxygen or carbon dioxide, they delays the respiration as well as that is and ripening as well as the retarding mold and the yeast growth. Agar waha pe oxygen and carbon dioxide ka combination ek proper proportion mein hota hai, to waha pe ek to respiration waha pe delay hota hai, ripening fruits ka waha pe delay hota hai, and at the same time they prevent the growth of mold and yeast. So that's why that carbon dioxide is also used in the preservation of fruits or vegetables. And the final result is that is extended storage of the such products, which can be beneficial or advantageous for the transportation of that fruits and vegetables. And at the same time, consumption of these fruits and vegetables during the off season. Okay. क्योंकि अगर हम प्रिजर्व कर सकते हैं अच्छी कंडीशन में अच्छी तरह से, तो दैट कैन बी ईटन बाय द ह्यूमन हियर इन द ऑफ सीजन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर फ्रूट हियर, और दैट कैन बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन. सो दिस इज द मेन एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस एक्सटेंडिंग ऑफ द स्टोरेज लाइफ ऑफ द फ्रूट एंड वेजिटेबल्स बाय यूजिंग दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. देन अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड दैट इज नियरली 5 to 10%, इट इज एक्चुअली डिटरमाइंड बाय द फैक्टर्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल the nature of that particular food product or fruit here, then type or variety of the food product, climate available, where you are storing that food material, or the extent of storage. Matlab kitne din tak aapko wahan pe storage karna hai. Next chemical preservatives are called as the nitrates and nitrites. So generally these preservatives, these are used for the meat for centuries in the hams, bacon, or that bolonga hot dogs, and in the meat sausages or the sausages here. But generally their use of these nitrites and nitrates, they produces a cured meat flavor, and they helps to stabilize the pink color of the meat or meat products here. मतलब जो एक्चुअल जो थोड़ा सा उतना पिंक भी हम पूरा नहीं कह सकते, लेकिन रेड पिंकिश जो कलर होता है मीट और मीट प्रोडक्ट्स का, सो दैट कैन बी स्टेबलाइज बाय यूजिंग दिस नाइट्रेट्स एंड नाइट्राइड्स. दिस नाइट्राइड्स दे प्रिवेंट द ग्रोथ ऑफ क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम बॉटुलिनम विच इज अ पॉजिटिव एजेंट ऑफ बॉटुलिज्म फूड पॉइजनिंग. एंड दिस बैक्टीरिया दैट इज क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम बॉटुलिनम, इट प्रोड्यूसेस और इट सीक्रेट अ हाईली टॉक्सिक टॉक्सिन. That is the botulinum toxin, we can call it as a, and these bacteria are anaerobic in nature, so that's why they are generally present in the interior or in the inside of the meat or meat product. So that has been done as a vacuum package, kyunki surface pe agar kuch bhi microorganism usme nahi hai, fir bhi jo pathogens jo microorganisms if they are present inside the meat product here, so that can remain as it is. These microorganisms remain as it is because they are anaerobic in nature, and mostly they prefer the anaerobic condition for their growth. Okay, but however, it is found that nitrite has the ability to react with the amino acids present in the proteins of meat and meat products, and there is a formation of nitrosoamines. Okay, so amino acids jo present hote hain proteins mein, meat mein jo hote hain proteins usme, because proteins are made up of amino acids. And these nitrites, they react with these amino acids, and there is a formation of nitrosoamines takes place. These nitrosoamines, they have been reported to cause the liver cancers in the animals. Okay, so ye animals mein liver cancers cause kar sakte, to unke residues wahan pe ja sakte, matlab animals ki body mein, and they will cause the liver cancer here. Next preservative jo hai, chemical preservatives, that is antioxidants. So these antioxidants, these are beneficial in preventing the rancidity of the fats as well as those foods which consist of the fats. Kyunki jo if you will keep that oil for a longer period, so there is some bad smell occurs of that oil, and that is due to the rancidity of the fats here. Okay, or those food which consist of the fats. But if you want to prevent this rancidity of the fat or fatty products here or foods, then there is a these antioxidants, they can do this thing here, or they prevent the rancidity. So that fats which are exposed to the light, moisture, heat, or heavy metal ions, they become activated and oxidized. So they to peroxides. Okay, and the most used antioxidants in the food material, that includes butylated hydroxy anisole, then butylated hydroxy toluene, then propyl galate, then natural or synthetic tocopherols, that is vitamin E, ascorbic acid, that is vitamin C, and lecithin. So these are the some antioxidants which are added in the food material or in the fruits or vegetables here. So that BHA and BHT, that is butylated hydroxy anisole and butylated hydroxy toluene, they are the frequency of using of these antioxidants in the different types of products here. So they become relatively stable to heat as well as that can be maintained their effect in the cooked products here also, even in the cooked products also. Then next point is here, that is called as the color additives. Okay, additives. So the acceptance of food products, it is determined legally by its appearance. Then consumers become accustomed to standardized colors in a familiar foods, and as well as base of their purchasing the habits or the decisions or the past experience. मतलब अगर हम कुछ color additives food में add करते हैं, तो ये depend that customers पे है कि whether they are accepting that food material or not. Because if the taste of that food material changes after addition of that particular colors, so at that time definitely that customers, they will does not purchase that food products here, and that's why the color additives should be such that can at least keep or maintain the smell, taste, as well as the texture of that particular food material. And in order to improve the color of that foods, that colorants or synthetic colors or natural colors, these are added to the carbonated beverages, for example, here. Then in the frozen desserts, for example, in some dairy products, as well as in bakery products. Color to hum matlab jalebi bhi agar hum dekhenge to usme wahan pe synthetic color use kiya jata hai, artificial color wahan pe use kiya jata hai, to so that gives the color to the jalebi also. And some bakery products, dairy products, then some carbonated beverages, so that color compounds are added here. We can call it as a color additives, so that can be actually, they does not change the flavor of the or taste of the food material. Now there are some flavor additives are also there. So natural food flavors, they are rarely used because the methods which are required to obtain the particular amount of that flavor, this is very expensive. Barabar hai? To agar hum kuch matlab natural flavor ke hum kuch agar hume tayar karne hai components ya fir compounds, so generally you will require a large quantity of that particular food products here, or fruits for example, to and that will become very expensive. Agar aapko natural flavors aapko produce karna hai, to jo natural product hum use karenge wahan pe, food product agar hum use karenge to uske liye wahan pe bahut jyada quantity unki lagti hai, and that will be very expensive. And in addition, they may are not uniform in the flavor quality or chemical composition. And the main availability of such natural flavor additives, that is dependent on the particular season. Okay, because particular season mein agar natural fruits agar hum use kar rahe flavor ke liye ya natural flavor ke liye, to wo fruits wagaire jo rahenge wo hame use particular season mein available ho jayenge. Okay. और अवेलेबल होने के बाद भी अगर हम उसे नेचुरल फ्लेवर प्रोड्यूस करने में अगर हम उसे यूज करेंगे, तो दैट विल बिकम वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. एंड सपोज दैट मैन्युफैक्चरर्स, दे वांटेड टू प्रोड्यूस अ बनाना आइसक्रीम फॉर एग्जांपल, सो इट विल टेक, एक एग्जांपल उन्होंने दिया है कि सो ये बनाना आइसक्रीम अगर आपकी आपको बनानी है, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इफ दैट मैन्युफैक्चरर वॉन्ट टू टेक अ नेचुरल फ्लेवर ऑफ बनाना फॉर एग्जाम्पल, so it will take, or the, that manufacturer will require 5 tons of bananas to extract 1/2 liter of banana oil. Okay, matlab agar aapko 1/2 liter hi banana oil agar aapko extract karna hai as a flavor karke ice cream ke liye, to manufacturer ko 5 ton banana unko lagenge, to ye 5 ton banana se they will extract 1/2 liter of banana oil, and then it can be used for a or as a फ्लेवर एडिटिव इन द आइसक्रीम, बनाना आइसक्रीम. एक टन मतलब हाउ मेनी क्विंटल
सर? 17?
नो
सर, 1000 केजी.
हाँ, 1000 केजी मीन्स हाउ मेनी क्विंटल? यस, यू आर राइट. 1000 केजी विल रिक्वायर 1000 केजी ऑफ, that is 1000 kg equal to 1 ton. Okay, but 1000 1000 kg means how many quintal? Anybody?
1000, 1 quintal is 100 kg,
right? 1 quintal, it is equal to 100 kg. So 1000 kg means it is 10 quintal. Okay, 100 kg, 100 kg means 1 quintal.
Yes,
so 1000 kg, it means 10 quintal here. Okay, so that 10 quintal or 1000 kg, it is equal to 1 ton. Okay, so that manufacturer will require 5 tons, that means 50,000 kg of bananas to extract 1/2 liter of banana oil. And that's why these natural flavors, these are very expensive, and therefore if the demand of that flavoring agents in our food supply is to be met, so it is very essential to produce that artificial flavorings. Okay, or that is the need of our, if the demand of that flavoring agents is more, then that artificial flourus should be produced here, and that flowering agents which are commonly used, these are generally esters, pentyl acetate, which are responsible for the banana flavor. Okay, that ester pentyl acetate response, that is or that can be used as a supplement, we can say here, for the natural banana flavor. And aldehydes, benzaldehydes, that is used as a cherry flavor. Okay, so the next one is here, that is about the sweeteners. So these are added in different types of foods to increase or to enhance the taste of the food material, and that can be classified as a nutritive, or that can another one is the non-nutritive, because there are some sweeteners are there which are nutritive, and there are some non-sweeteners are there, that is sweeteners are there which are non-nutritive. मतलब उसमें से हमें कुछ भी nutrient नहीं मिलते हैं, लेकिन कुछ sweeteners ऐसे होते हैं जहाँ से हमें nutrient मिलते हैं. Okay, so that nutritive sweeteners, they consist of the calories, because they are metabolized by our body or by the cells, and they produces the energy. And examples of these nutritive sweeteners includes sucrose, glucose, that is dextrose, fructose or invert sugar, and high fructose corn syrup. So these are the some sweeteners or nutritive sweeteners here. They provide energy to us, or that can be used, our body can be produce or synthesize energy from these sweeteners. Then high fructose corn syrup, it is produced from the corn syrups, and that is treated with an enzyme called as glucose isomerase. So this glucose isomerase, it converts that sugar or that fructose into the that converts the syrup or corn syrup to the product which consists of 42% fructose and 50% glucose here. तो इस तरह से यहाँ पे मतलब ये जो कुछ स्वीटनर्स है जिससे हमें न्यूट्रिएंट्स भी मिलते हैं, और दिस एज अ स्वीटनर्स कर से वो काम करते हैं. देन फर्दर फ्रैक्शनेशन ऑफ दैट 42% हाई फ्रुक्टोज शुगर्स हियर, दैट रिजल्ट्स इनटू द सेकंड जनरेशन शुगर्स, एंड दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द 90% फ्रुक्टोज. सो दिस फ्रुक्टोज, इट इज अ स्वीटनर, आइदर सुक्रोज और ग्लूकोज. The use of this high fructose consisting sugars in food products that permits the smaller amount of sugar that is added to the soft drinks. मतलब ये जो sugar होती है soft drinks में, या फिर उसे हम sweetener कह सकते हैं दोस्तों, that gives the energy also, and that can be act as a sweeteners. Then another one is here, that is called as the non-nutritive sweeteners. For example, saccharin is there. So the saccharin, though it is a sweetener, but it does not provide calories because these are not metabolized in our body. Okay, so ye artificial hai, non-nutritive hai. At the same time, another sweetener is here, that is called as the aspartame. So it is also a non-nutritive sweetener, and even though it is metabolized in our body into different amino acids, one is the phenylalanine and second one is the aspartic acid. So the level of this aspartame used is extremely small in our body, and that aspartame, it is needed to produce the sweetness that is equivalent to the sucrose, which is a natural sugar. Then next one is here, that is called as the emulsifiers. So these emulsifiers, they allows that molecules that are mutually antagonistic, water and oil for example here, to mix together. मतलब अगर emulsifier हम उसमें डालते हैं particular food material में, for example, so these emulsifiers, they allow the that are mutually antagonistic to the mix together. So water and oil, that can be mixed if you added the emulsifiers. At the same time, these emulsifiers, they improve the texture of that food material, volume and the body of bakery goods or baked goods by even distribution of that components or the even distribution of the ingredients of food material. And one of the most important or used emulsifier is lecithin, which is present in the or which is naturally present in milk, eggs as well as in soybeans. So ye is tarah se humne chemical preservatives yahan pe dekhe, different types of chemical preservatives. So friends, the next point we are going to see, that is about the foodborne diseases. So that foodborne diseases, these are, or that can be caused by the bacteria or the toxins, bacterial toxins that may be caused by the viruses, fungi or the fungal toxins, or maybe that foodborne diseases due to parasites or protozoans or some pesticide residues present in the food, then drug residues present in the food material, heavy metals, food adulterants, as well as food additives. So all these factors, they are responsible for the foodborne diseases. But among these, that microbiological contaminants or the microorganisms, these are the most important context for of developing countries here. So that is mainly involved in the occurrence of foodborne infections or food poisoning. And to date, there are near about 250 different types of foodborne diseases are described. And out of that, that bacteria, these are the causative agents of 2/3 of these total 250 foodborne diseases. So among these predominant bacteria, which are mainly responsible for the causation of that foodborne infections or foodborne diseases, that includes Escherichia coli, Salmonella species, then Shigella species, Bacillus cereus, Clostridium species, then Staphylococcus aureus, Vibrio cholerae, then monocytogenes, then Campylobacter, then Yersinia, Brucella species, as well as Mycobacterium. So these are the different types of bacteria which causes or which are mainly involved in the foodborne infections or foodborne diseases. And among viruses, that rotaviruses, noroviruses, then hepatitis, that is A and E, they are mainly involved in the causation of this foodborne infections or foodborne diseases. So why need for the foodborne pathogens surveillance here? So growing international trade here, migration, as well as traveling, they are tremendously increasing the spread of these dangerous pathogens as well as contaminants in the food material. Because transportation is there, migration is there, traveling is there, international trade is there, and all these things, they are contributing to the spreading of that dangerous pathogens from one country to another country, for example, or the contaminants in the food material. And this globalization of that food marketing and distribution, that is by both accidentally or as well as deliberately, they are contaminating the food products and they are affecting the health of humans in many countries at the same time. So in today's interconnected as well as interdependent world, because all these countries in the world, they are interconnected with each other and at the same time, they are interdependent. Okay, for in these countries or in the world, that local foodborne diseases outbreaks, they become a potential threat to the whole world or to the entire globe, because all these countries, they are interconnected as well as interdependent. And in 1991, that cholera, which was thought to have originated in or from the contaminated seafood that is harvested off in the coast of Peru, they rapidly spreads across the Latin America, which results into the 4 lakh cases and more than 4,000 deaths in many countries. So originating in one country, for example, that is in the coast of Peru, but it spread rapidly throughout the Latin America and to the other countries also. And in early 2008, that outbreak of avian influenza in Bangalore, India, led to an import ban, that is ban of Indian poultry products in the Middle East. मतलब बेंगलोर में एवियन इन्फ्लुएंजा होने की वजह से जो इंपोर्ट मतलब वहां पे किया जाता था या फिर हमारे यहाँ से एक्सपोर्ट किया जाता वहां पे बैन आ गया है एंड दैट रिजल्ट्स इनटू द लॉसेस टोटलिंग ऑफ हंड्रेड्स टू और थाउजेंड्स ऑफ यूनाइटेड स्टेट डॉलर टू द इंडियन इकोनॉमी. तो इस तरह से अगर मतलब कुछ फूडबॉर्न इन्फेक्शन होते हैं, दैट मे बी फ्रॉम द मीट और मीट प्रोडक्ट्स, दैट मे बी फ्रॉम द पोल्ट्री प्रोडक्ट्स, सो दे आर रिजल्टिंग इन द डेथ्स ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग एज वेल एज लॉस ऑफ इकोनॉमी. And identification of one single contaminated food ingredient, it can lead to the recall of tons of food products from the market. That results into the economic loss in production as well as and from trade embargoes as well as damage to the टूरिस्ट इंडस्ट्री, मतलब एक भी अगर कुछ कंटेमिनेटेड फूड इंग्रेडिएंट वहां पे निकलता है तो पूरे क्वांटिटी को, मतलब जो भी मार्केट में भेजी या फिर ट्रांसपोर्ट की गई है उन सभी को वहां पे रिकॉल करना पड़ता है, वो सब फूड मटेरियल वहां पे वापस लेना पड़ता है, एंड दैट विल कॉजेस द लॉस टू द फूड इंडस्ट्री और टू द प्रोडक्शन ईयर लाइक दैट. देन से दिस इज द फूडबॉर्न इन्फेक्शन और फूडबॉर्न डिसीजेस ईयर, दैट इज अ डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन. So that are caused by the agents that are enter in the body through the ingestion of food material, and that can occur when a pathogen or their toxins are consumed. Foodborne diseases कब होते हैं? एक तो अगर वो food में present है और ऐसे food contaminated food अगर हम ingest करते हैं तो वहाँ पे foodborne infections होते हैं, foodborne diseases होते हैं, या फिर pathogen या फिर उनका कोई toxin हम consume करते हैं, so that can occur that foodborne diseases here and commonly referred to as the food poisoning. अगर हम toxin वहाँ पे ले रहे तो, so that foodborne diseases can be classified into three different types. Which are that three different types of foodborne diseases? One is called as foodborne infection. That is caused due to the ingestion of viable pathogens along with food material. मतलब contaminated food के साथ अगर हम वो pathogens हमारे body में ले रहे viable pathogens, तो वहाँ पे टाइफाइड मतलब उसे हम फूडबॉर्न इन्फेक्शंस कहेंगे. दूसरा जो है दैट इज फूडबॉर्न इंटॉक्सिकेशंस. फूडबॉर्न इंटॉक्सिकेशंस का मतलब है कि और पॉइजनिंग, सो इंजेक्शन ऑफ फूड मटेरियल विच कंसिस्ट ऑफ द प्री फॉर्म टॉक्सिन. मतलब उस पर्टिकुलर फूड में अगर पहले से ही टॉक्सिन तैयार है और ऐसे फूड जब हम खाते हैं, इंजेस्ट करते हैं, तो उसे हम क्या कहें, जब इन्फेक्शन हमें होता है तो उसे हम कहेंगे फूड बॉर्न इंटॉक्सिकेशन और फूड बॉर्न पॉइजनिंग और सिंपली कॉल्ड एज फूड पॉइजनिंग. एग्जाम्पल्स है बॉटलिज्म फूड पॉइजनिंग और स्टैफिलोकोकल फूड पॉइजनिंग. और तीसरा जो टाइप है वो है टॉक्सिको इन्फेक्शन. सो दैट ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे प्रोड्यूस टॉक्सिन्स इन सीचू व्हेन दे आर इंजेस्टेड अलॉन्ग विद द फूड मटेरियल. मतलब जब कोई पैथोजन हम फूड मटेरियल के साथ इंजेस्ट करते हैं हमारे बॉडी में और अगर हम हमारे बॉडी में वो पैथोजन टॉक्सिन प्रोड्यूस करते हैं तो उसे हम क्या कहेंगे, टॉक्सिको इन्फेक्शन. सो दिस इज द डायग्राम विच एक्सप्लेन्स दैट थ्री फूड पॉइजनिंग और डिसीजेस, दैट इन्वेजन एंड द टॉक्सिन्स इन्वेजन, देन इंटॉक्सिकेशन. पैथोजन अगर हम डायरेक्टली ले रहे तो इंटॉक्सिकेशन है. इन्वेजन मतलब पैथोजन बॉडी में एंटर होकर टॉक्सिन वहां पे तैयार कर रहा है तो वहां पे टॉक्सिको इन्फेक्शन कहेंगे. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द, अगर टॉक्सिन अलॉन्ग विथ फूड हम इंजेस्ट कर रहे तो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इंटॉक्सिकेशन. पैथोजन हमारे बॉडी में एंटर हो रहा है और बाद में वो टॉक्सिन तैयार कर रहा है, देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज टॉक्सिको इन्फेक्शन. एंड इन्वेजन का मतलब है अगर पैथोजन हमारे बॉडी में एंटर होकर इन्फेक्शन कॉज कर रहे तो या फिर डिसीज कॉज कर रहे तो उसे हम कहेंगे इन्फेक्शन. तो दीज आर दी थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ दी फूडबॉर्न डिसीजेस. सो टुमारो वी विल सी अबाउट दी अनदर पॉइंट हियर, दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दैट फूडबॉर्न इन्फेक्शंस एंड इंटॉक्सिकेशन. इन्फेक्शन का डेफिनेशन मैंने बताया था कि जब पैथोजन हमारे बॉडी में एंटर होके डिसीज कॉज कर रहे तो उसे हम इन्फेक्शन कहेंगे. और इंटॉक्सिकेशन का मतलब है कि जो फूड में टॉक्सिन अगर प्रोडक्ट तैयार हो गया और वो फूड अगर हम खा रहे उसके बाद जो डिसीज हमें होता है, जो इन्फेक्शन हमें होता है, उसे हम